Time to build. A time I have seen the business that God has given to mortals to be busied about. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into their hearts so that they cannot find out from beginning to end the work which God alone has done. Word of the Lord.
Thanks. Your own book. memories of your time in Kelly's Island, big family vacations, the wonderful programs that were worked out, certain days doing certain things, the wonderful programs that were established for the children, all the meals that were planned, those stuffed cabbages that you made. Memories to hold on to, memories to reflect upon each and every day. And our beloved Doreen will live on in these memories and these thoughts that we hold very dear in our hearts. And I'm sure as you gather together this afternoon after Mass for the luncheon over at the funeral home, you will share those stories. Remember when we got together then? Remember when Doreen, you'll fill in those blanks and you'll share those wonderful memories that you hold. She'll live on in these memories. She'll live on in each and every one of you, beloved family and friends. But our faith tells us something even faith tells us that we who are faithful are called to live forever in the bright promise of eternal life in heaven. This is why our blessed Lord suffered and died on the cross. He did that out of love for us, so that we might have the possibility of eternal life in heaven. And that's not some pious platitude to make us feel better when we're sad. That's the reality of our Catholic faith. This is what we believe and hold dear in our hearts. We are very much aware of the profound love that our God has for us. He's not just up there somewhere far removed from us. But our God became incarnate. He became man and came into our world out of love. He suffered and he died on the cross out of love for us. That's the kind of love the God of the Christian has for his people. So always be mindful of that tremendous love of God in your life, and may that love be your consolation and hope. Always live in that love, the love of our blessed Lord, and reflect that love in your own hearts as you strive to live out the faith and to witness to the joy and the love and the peace of our blessed Lord. Once again, on behalf of all of us here in the parish, do know our heart, our prayers, and our sympathies as we pray together. We'd ask you now to please stand, and we'll have our petitions. Thank you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, honor, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection is gone, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without him we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
We all need.
Also use this time though Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son loved us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strength and might. Our sister, your maid, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever. We ask that.